So hello everyone, I hope you're doing good, and this is Vansh. So in this video we're going to talk about part 2 of American education system. So part 1 is here, it's already out. So this is the part 2 in which I will cover a few points, and then I will upload a part 3 as well of this video. So the part 3 link will be here once it gets uploaded. So definitely go and check them out once the part 3 is uploaded. So definitely subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. And follow me on Instagram as well, because I post reels quite often there and I am very much active over there. And also do check them out. So do follow me on Instagram, subscribe to my channel, like this video, and that's it. So let's get into the video. So now you have become pretty much aware of what an American education system looks like. So now I will tell you that the fourth point, and that's you get to decide your own roadmap of your education. So what does that mean? So basically you will be given the full freedom to decide how you want to pursue your course. So like, suppose if I give you an example, in India basically there are a set of courses that you have to take to get your education. Those are the defined set of courses. You cannot change them. There is no option that you can change the course. You have to take it, and those are mandatory. But here the case is not the same. So basically here what happens, you have to decide your own. They will give you a list of GEA courses, that those are taught by your university. And from those lists you have to decide that which courses you want in your GE, and also in the major. So there will be list of courses that you can take for your major. Like suppose if I'm taking computer science, there will be a list of computer science courses that is available at the university, and then I have to choose those courses which interest me a lot or which I want to take in computer science towards my degree. So that's how it works. So this is the best thing I like about the American education system, that you get to choose your own structure, your own roadmap, and you can plan it the way you want. Okay, so this transitions into our fifth and sixth point. Those are related to the fourth point. So our fifth point is that there is no time foundation. So if I give you the example of India, so basically there is a time foundation that you have to complete your course within the 4 years or maybe 3 years depending upon the course. They will have a predefined set of semester that you have to take. That suppose your first semester is running from September to December, and your second semester is running from January to May, and then you have a break in between, and then again it continues. So you have to do this for 4 years. So that restricts the student's freedom to do the things, do pursue his education according to his own wish. But here the case is different. So basically here there is no time foundation, especially for the local people, like those are local to this country. So they can complete their bachelor's degree in any amount of time they want. If they want to complete their bachelor's degree in 8 years, they can complete. If they want to complete the bachelor's degree in 10 years, 15, 20, any amount of years do they want, they can complete. But for the international students, it is just restricted to a maximum of 5 years. So you have to complete your education within the 5 years, or you can extend it with university's permission. If your university allows you to extend your 5 years, then you can extend it. But generally it's 5 years, because then the international students can exploit their education for living in the US. So for that reason, they have a upper limit on international students, but they don't have any limit on the locals living here. So, and also you get to decide that which semester you want to take. So suppose there are mainly three semesters. One is the fall semester that runs from August or September to December. The second semester is spring semester that runs from January to April or May, and the third semester is your summer semester that runs from May to August. So basically they have three semesters, and now the university will give you the choice that in which semester do you want to continue with your studies. So suppose if I'm doing my first semester in fall semester, that is from August to December, now there is no compulsion for me that I have to take the spring semester as well, that will run from January to April. I can leave that semester for a holiday break, that I'm going for a holiday, or maybe I just want to rest, maybe I want to explore the area, so I'm taking off. So I can take off, and then I can continue my education from the summer semester that runs from April to August. So there is no foundation on this. And also if I want, I can take that summer semester also off, and then I can straight away go with the fall semester of the next year once again. So that's how flexible the education system of America is. There is no foundation, but as I told you that there is a foundation on the number of years you have to complete your education, so you have to abide by that. So you have to plan your whole structure according to that timing, and you have to make sure that you do not exceed those timings. Because suppose if you are taking straight away off from the university for like almost a year, but then you have an upper limit that you have to complete your education in 5 years, so then you will be required to pace up with your studies, pace up with the number of courses you are taking throughout the semester. So that you also have to take take into consideration. And the next point, sixth point, that is you can leave and you can continue your education, your bachelor's degree or master's degree whenever you want. So if I give you an example of India, so if you leave your bachelor's degree or master's degree in between for any reason, suppose there is a marriage or maybe there are some adverse circumstances that occurred in your family because of which you have to leave your education, so then the Indian education system won't give you the credits for the education you have completed so far. So then if you want to again pursue your education, you have to basically start from the very beginning. They won't consider that you have left in between. So that's one of the main drawbacks of Indian education system, which has now been resolved by the National Education Policy of 2021 by Narendra Modi, or I think it's 2020 and I'm not sure about the year. So but in the American education system, you can leave your education whenever you want and then you can continue. So what happens is, suppose if I want to discontinue with my studies after completing my 2 years out of 4 years, okay, so I can do that. So after completing 1 year, I will get a diploma. After completing 2 years, I will get an associate degree. After completing 3 years, I will get a bachelor's degree. After completing 4 years, I will get an honors degree. So even if you started with a bachelor's degree, you can end up with an associate degree, and then after any amount of time, like suppose 4 years, 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, 30 years, even, or whenever you want. So you can continue with your education from that level. So suppose if you ended up with the second year, so basically you will have to continue from third year. You won't be required to do the first and second year once again because you have already done, you have got the credits, so you don't have to repeat it. You just have to do the remaining credits to get your degree. So that's how it works. Also, the seventh point is that the mode of examination is totally different from India. Like in India, what happens, they will give you some assignments, like only 1 to 2 assignments throughout the semester, but your main grade will depend on your final exam. So basically students, they just chill out throughout the semester, but at the end, when the final exams are around the corner, so they study whole night, they study for a week, and then they pass with good grades. So that's what typically happens in India. But in American education system, every course, they will give you assignments every week, and those assignments will count towards your final grade. So basically, it's not only the final exam that will account towards your final grade. Your assignments will also count towards your final grade. Your midterms, your participation in the class, your activities, those will also count towards your final grade. So suppose if you do miss any one of the assignments, your grade will lower down. If you missed more than one assignment, your grade will become much lower than it was. Even if you score full marks in your finals, even if you score full marks in your activities or some or other things, but if you miss some of the assignments, then your grades will be lower. Why? Because every assignment matters, every assignment counts towards the final grade, every activity, your participation in the class, everything counts towards the final grade. So here you always have to study every week. They will give you some assignments, small assignments, big assignments, that depend on the instructor or the course, but they will generally give you assignments every week which you have to complete. So you are basically studying every week about your course to get the marks for your assignment. So you're never out of the touch, and also when the final exam comes up, you're already in touch with everything what happened in the class, every section of the course. So you are not rushing at the end of for studying for your finals. Like in India, you are studying late night, you are studying 18 hours a day, 10 hours a day, 5 hours a day. So it's basically not that. That's a great thing, but at the same time, you're always occupied with some work, because suppose if you're taking 5 to 6 courses a semester, so every course will give you assignments to do every week. So you have 5 to 6 assignments, and then you also have your part-time job. Maybe you, if you have, then also you have to do your grocery. If you're living independently, you have to make your dishes, you have to do cooking, you have to do cleanings, and then you also have to do your assignments. So it becomes very hectic, but it's a very great thing. So I think this video has become so long, but yeah, do let me know in the comment section that which education system do you think is better, which education system is more flexible. I hope you liked this video. So if you did, so do make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel, and also do follow me on Instagram for regular updates, and also I post reels quite often, so do follow me on Instagram as well, and I will see you guys in the next one. Till then, take care, bye bye. Love from California, boy from India, peace.